Gina Pane, ACTION PSYCHÈ, 1973-1974. We are here in Francisco Carolina, it's the house of media art and photography of the Oberösterreichische Landeskultur GmbH, where I've been art media Dresden since about 8 years now. Gina Pane was one of the most radical performance artists of her time, and she was a seminal figure of body art movement in Europe in the 1970s. Born 1939 in Paris, France, she studied painting at the École des Beaux-Arts in Paris, France. In 1965, she found herself at the limitation of painting and moved towards a sculptural practice where she built spaces for visitors to get in. This maybe is the first hint to what later is her performance art, performance work. In the ACTION PSYCHÈ, she wants to incorporate a language coming from body to body, an act of communication from one individual to another individual without language. In this room here, we find 25 photographs and a covered slideshow with 75 color slides, some action drawings, and some relics of her performance. ACTION PSYCHÈ took part on January 12, 1973 in the Gallery Stadler in Paris. It was a performance in front of audience. When talking about performance art, audience is a huge issue because with the audience there's a real witness. There's somebody I can take my actions to. I can address somebody with my actions. Maybe we have a look at the photographs here. Let's have a look at ACTION PSYCHÈ. We have the 25 photographs here. In the beginning, I want to mention she always worked together with the same photograph artist, and this was her girlfriend because she was an open homosexual, and she was called Françoise Masson. In a few settings, you see there's kind of intimate view on her girlfriend's body. In the beginning, up there, you see a few in the Galerie Stadler, outside the window, and then in the second setting, she really goes in media space, drawing lips and eyes on a mirror. The mirror I will show you afterwards in the case with the relics. In the next setting, she cuts herself above the eyebrow. In this view from down here, it maybe looks like a woman plucking her eyebrows as a cosmetic gesture, but in the end she cuts herself in there. Cutting yourself in the face as a woman is like a negotiation of femininity, which is a huge part in her work too. In the next photograph you see that a drop of blood is falling down the mirror, and at the end of the row you see that Gina Pane has tears of blood in her face. After this climax in the beginning, there comes a playful part, it's like a chill out atmosphere where she gets self-caring with feathers and balls, massaging herself and trying to love inside these pictures. Afterwards, she takes a bandage around her eyes and the blood from the cuts runs through the bandage, so there are this kind of red spots on the bandage. In the middle row here, you see Gina Pane acting and doing some gestures. She talks to him or she takes attention to her audience and makes some gestures, and it looks a little bit spooky maybe too. With this gesture, she really turns towards her audience, and as I told you in the beginning, Gina Pane wanted to create, to incorporate a language from one body to another body. So not a language spoken, but a very immediately, a very instant reaction from one body to another body. In language, we have the problem, the issue that we can't express pain. You can talk about pain, but if I feel pain, you will never know if you can also feel the same pain like I do. So there's this limit of language. In this work, ACTION PSYCHÈ, Gina Pane wanted to overcome this limit of language with this direct act of communication from one body to another body, dealing with the wound. So when you see the wound of a person, maybe your body reacts instantly. Many times it does. It depends on how compassionate you are, how empathetic you are, and you feel maybe a kind of shiver or a kind of crumbling down. When it comes further, Gina Pane acts with her breast and tries to kiss her breast, and then there comes the next climax, like the waves going up again, where Gina Pane cuts herself in the belly. You see it here, where she cuts herself and she makes four cuts around the navel. The navel is the center of the body and it's also the first wound you get in life. It's the first wound a mammal or a human has when cutting the umbilical cord. So with this existential wound, she deals here. Don't forget that this wound also makes you living on your own. So it's the first time when a baby breathes, is when the umbilical cord is cut down. You see the blood around the navel, and you then see again the chilling and the relaxing atmosphere, and Gina Pane again comes with the feathers and moves towards herself in a self-caring mode. Gina Pane does not cut herself because of autoaggression or because of some other emotions towards herself, but because of love and devotion for herself. Self-injury in the action setting is a part, an act of love and devotion, where she can connect with her audience. In her work, it is about transforming society and acting with her audience. She, as a child of her time, is in the middle of the social upheavals in Paris 1968 with the student protests, and she wants to make a change in society and to waken up the apathetic society, as she self wrote. And with this action here, there is the situation that the audience becomes a witness of this cutting, of this self-injury. In theory, maybe it sounds a bit complicated, but let me give you an example, very down to earth. I like walking barefoot a lot, so I incorporated the practice of going barefoot once a week for 1,000 steps each. And as we are in Austria now, and here, we have rough winters, and I also walk barefoot in winters. And last weekend it happened, I went barefoot through the woods, and when travelers or other people walking down the road, the woods, come and see me, they are like, oh, what are you doing there? Please put on your shoes. And then I say, no, I do it once a week, it's okay, I can deal with it. But this actual shivering, this reaction comes immediate, comes instantly. There is no thought in between. I think this is what Gina Pane wants to reach with her ACTION PSYCHÈ. In this room you also find action drawings. She calls it working notes for ACTION PSYCHÈ trial, where you find a drawing for each setting. This is also the connection to the photographs, because in this tableau of the 25 photographs, see how precisely Gina Pane puts together her artwork. And here you see how precisely Gina Pane prepares for her artworks. She also has the colors of the balls. There's the green ball, there's the blue, the yellow ball, and each ball stands for something different. In the end of the guided tour, I want to show you two cases with the relics of the exhibition. And for me, there it all comes together suddenly, because, you know, the one thing are the photographs, the other thing are the drawings, and the third thing are the color slides. But here you see the original relics from from the exhibition of 1973. And when I first saw this, a little shiver came above me, where you also are at the communication from body to body again, because on this mirror you see the blood that she poured on this glass in the action. You also see the clothes she wore, you see the balls, the feathers, and another action drawing. And this is kind of erratic here. I hope you enjoyed the guided tour, and I wish that you maybe can come here to watch it in original after the end of the lockdown. Next room we have Heiyu Chang, Golden Sunshine, a performance artist from China. And in end of February we will open Yasha exhibition in Kassel Museum, who also deals with performance art.